Okay, let's focus on the anatomy of the heart. The heart is going to look something like so. Something like that. Not a perfect drawing of the heart, but it's going to work for us. And just so we're all in the proper orientation, this is superior and this is inferior. This heart is facing us in standard anatomical position. The superior most aspect of the heart is known as the base of the heart. And over here, just left of center, is the apex of the heart. Base of the heart, it's somewhat of a misnomer because it's towards the top. Nonetheless, this is the base of the heart and this is the apex of the heart. The heart has four chambers, which really look nothing like this. It's a challenge for me to draw the heart in just two dimension because it's a three-dimensional structure. But part of this equation is these structures at the top. We have a right atrium and a left atrium, plural of atrium or atria. So we have a right and left atria. The atrium, truth be known, are really on the posterior aspect of the heart. When you're looking at the heart from in front of the heart is facing you in standard anatomical position. Really, all you're seeing are the ventricles. So below the atria, we have a right ventricle and a left ventricle. Right ventricle and a left ventricle. So like I suggested, the atria are receiving chambers. Whereas the ventricles are pumps. They are actually what are creating pressure gradients to allow blood to be pumped either to the lungs or throughout the whole body. Throughout the lungs or to the whole body. The pumping action of the heart, the whole purpose of the heart pumping or contracting is to create a pressure gradient. We're not going to talk in great detail about pressure gradients within anatomy, but we will talk about it in tremendous detail within human physiology. Okay, so the left ventricle is what's known as the systemic pump. It is the pump for our systemic circulation. And when I'm talking about systemic circulation, I am talking about system-wide, body-wide, everywhere in the body. So it's going to be pumping blood to the brain, it's going to be pumping blood to the GI tract, it'll be pumping blood to the pancreas. It'll be pumping blood to the liver. It'll be pumping blood to the big toe. So it is pumping blood to every tissue in the body. Every tissue in the body. Because every tissue in the body needs nutrients and oxygen to sustain themselves. The systemic circulation is pumping blood everywhere and also to the heart itself. Now, this may be somewhat confusing for me to suggest it's pumping blood to the heart. So just bear with me. But when the heart is pumping blood to itself, that's known as the coronary circulation. So when we are looking at this heart right here, the heart is an organ and it's composed of tissues. And one of the major components of the heart is the myocardium. Myocardium, which is the heart muscle. And the heart muscle needs nutrients and oxygen just like every other tissue in the body. So a subset of the systemic circulation is the coronary circulation. The coronary circulation is just describing the part of the systemic circulation that is specifically going to the myocardium, to the heart muscle. Okay, so that is systemic circulation. Once again, the pump for the systemic circulation is the left ventricle. The right ventricle serves as the pump for the pulmonary circulation. It is the pump for the pulmonary circulation. So pulmonary circulation, we'll highlight right here. The whole purpose of the pulmonary circulation is to pump blood to the lungs. Pulmonary refers to the lungs. Lungs are going to look something like that. And this is specifically for gas exchange. Gas exchange occurs at the lungs, specifically exchanging gases with the blood that is coming from the heart, coming from the right ventricle. So the gas exchange is as follows. Picks up oxygen. So the whole, one of the vital functions of the cardiovascular system is to distribute oxygen throughout the whole body. But we need to pick that oxygen up first at the lungs before we can distribute it throughout the whole body. So we pick up oxygen at the lungs. So if we look back at the heart right here, we have a blood vessel leaving the right ventricle. In full transparency, the blood does not leave the right ventricle in this locality, but I am just drawing it there for now. Blood is going to leave the right ventricle and go to the lungs to pick up oxygen. Blood leaves the right ventricle to go to the lungs to pick up oxygen. But it is also dropping off carbon dioxide. So this is oxygen. This is carbon dioxide. Moving back up here, once again, leaving the right ventricle, which is the pump for the pulmonary circulation. So we're going to say this is going to the lungs. So the blood can pick up oxygen and get rid of CO2. Pick up oxygen and get rid of CO2. Okay, we are going to end the video here, and we will have another video that explains